I apologize to anybody who was watching the first attempt I tried to make it playing Mass Effect there. I have to run my broadcaster software in administrator mode for it to recognize that Mass Effect is a program that it can capture. Go figure. Maybe, just maybe, it will work now. A little glitchy for some reason. It's kind of an older game, so, 2008's, God, about 6 years old. Still great, I think. The graphics are a little dated, but that's not really a problem. Give me a second here. We'll see if I can get it to recognize that it's doing things. Oh, maybe. Just maybe. If all else fails, I'll switch it over to The Witcher or something a little more easy to manage, but I would like to get this to work. Ooh, that's a very green. Much better. Okay.
Welcome to
Start this
Alliance
career thing all
Military
over again.
Database.
Now that we're actually
Classified
streaming. So
information
anyone who's
requested.
watching, welcome, welcome, welcome.
Establishing secure connection. Secure connection confirmed. Please log in to
I'm just gonna
access your
change
profile.
his name is Archibald. Because old-timey naval names are funny. Sounds like an admiral, Rear Admiral Archibald Shepherd.
Warning, data corruption detected. Please reconstruct profile.
Okay, I will.
Confirm pre-service history. Confirm
Earthborn.
psychological profile.
I'm
Confirm
rootless.
military specialized.
I'm a
Confirm
soldier.
facial identification.
Sure,
Profile
same thing
reconstruction
there.
complete.
All right. I'll go back for the people who haven't played this
Confirm
game before.
confirm
So,
confirm psych confirm
you have three
pre-service
choices
history.
on your pre-service history. Spacer, you're born in space. Military parents. Colonist, you're not a colonist. They kill everybody and you're saved by the military. And Earthborn, you were a thief, now you're no longer a thief because the military. Oh.
Confirm
Earthborn is good
psychological
for me in this
profile.
case, but I think rather than being a soul survivor. Actually, no. Soul survivor is probably the way I'll go, rather than war hero or ruthless. No, I'm gonna be ruthless. I'll just
Confirm
be an asshole to
military
everybody.
specialization.
And I'm gonna be a
Confirm
soldier.
faith profile reconstruction complete.
Nobody likes Archibald Shepherd.
Identification confirmed.
No auto. Good, good, good. Okay. Here we go.
Well, what about Shepard? Earthborn, but no record of his family.
That's right.
Doesn't have one. He was raised on the streets,
The
learned to look out
streets.
for himself.
He got most of his unit killed on Torfin.
Oh, well, that's.
He gets the job done, no matter what.
Is that the kind of person we want
Yes, it's
protecting
the
the
only
galaxy?
kind of person we can have protecting the galaxy.
That's the only kind of person who can protect
Okay, so
the
it's
galaxy.
relatively scripted. That line comes
I'll
up no
make the
matter
call.
what, but I think it's hilarious, personally. All right, in 2048, 2148, explorers on Mars discovered the remains of ancient space-bearing civilization. Decades that followed, the mysterious artifacts revealed startling new technologies, enabling travel to the furthest stars. Based on the incredible technology that was a force controlled the very fabric of space and time, they call it the greatest discovery in human history. The civilizations of the galaxy call it Mass Effect, which doesn't make a lot of sense to me, but whatever. Why they would call it Mass Effect.
The Arcturus Prime relay's in range. Initiating transmission sequence.
Commander.
Anytime Seth Green is in your voice cast, you know you've done a pretty damn good job. Because he doesn't go out of his way to do stuff.
Calculating transit mass and destination. Relay is hot. Acquiring approach vector. All stations secure for transit.
No matter what this game is, I think it's epic. It has an epic quality. Not like epic, but...
Board is green. Approach run has begun.
There's an epicness to it, in the way it's shot, the direction of it. Excuse me.
Thrusters, check. Navigation, check. Internal emissions sync engaged. All systems online. Drift, just under 1,500K.
1,500 is good. Your captain will be pleased.
So, we've got humans.
I hate that guy.
And as Joker hates...
Nihilus gave you a compliment.
The Turians.
So you hate him.
You remember to zip up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead. So that's incredible. Besides, Spectres are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid.
You're paranoid. The Council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. But only an idiot believes the official story.
Ever since Knights of the Old Republic, BioWare has really upped their... or just had been on top of the voice acting game. Let's be a dick.
That's enough. You're soldiers. Act like it.
Yeah.
Sorry, Commander.
Joker, status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance Brass before we reach Eden Prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihilus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant. Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
Oh,
you get that,
Green.
Commander?
Great. You pissed the captain off, and now I'm going to pay for it.
Don't blame me. The captain's always in a bad mood.
Only when he's talking to you, Joker.
The writing is just so sharp. Let's start exploring. Press O. Here's my codex. Okay. Basic tutorials. Of the Normandy.
We're getting... Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down to see the captain?
Sounds like you don't trust our Turian guest.
Sorry, Commander. Just having a chat with Adams down at Engineering. I didn't mean to cause any trouble. But you have to admit, something's odd about this mission. The whole crew feels it.
You think the Alliance Brass is holding out on us?
Yeah, do you?
If all we're supposed to do is test out the stealth system, why is Captain Anderson in charge? And then there's Nihilus. Spectres are elite operatives, top covert agents. Why send a Spectre, a Turian Spectre, on a shakedown run?
Well, that's a good question.
Doesn't add up.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Yeah, you know I will.
Good luck, Commander.
I won't tell this guy, because he's a piece of crap, but I'll get some answers. That's definitely what I'll do. Mainly because the game wants to give me answers. I'm sure if Commander Shepard existed in real life, he'd just want to get the fuck out.
That's crazy. The captain.
Hello, Nihilus.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. It'll give us a chance to talk.
talk.
What about?
I'm interested
it's
in
never
this world
reflective
we're going
of the same
to.
Thing.
Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
I've never been there.
But know. You know of it. It's become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
Do you know something?
Yeah, do you?
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous
oh,
place.
Oh, galactic condescension,
is the
my
Alliance
favorite.
Truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the commander what's really going on.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
That's obvious.
I already figured that out.
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
What's the payload, Captain?
A research team unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
Prothean?
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years
ago.
See,
I like they fill that in for
Their
you.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
This is big, Shepard. The last time humanity made a discovery like this, it jumped our technology forward 200 years.
Oh, that's not
but
bad.
Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this. We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Okay.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
Are we expecting trouble?
I'm always expecting trouble.
There's more, Shepard.
So cliche.
Nihlus isn't just here for the beacon. He's also here to evaluate you.
Guess that explains why I bump into him every time I turn around.
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in
of
shaping interstellar
do.
Policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council.
It's the same
the Spectres
always.
Represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
I was impressed when I studied the reports from Torfin. A grim business, but you got the job done.
Oh, thank
That's
you.
Why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
Why would a Turian want a human in the Spectres?
Not all Turians resent humanity. Some of us see the potential of your species. We see what you have to offer to the rest of the galaxy, and to the Spectres. We are an elite group. It's rare to find an individual with the skills we seek. I don't care that you're human, Shepard. I only care that you can do the job.
Oh, thanks.
Just tell me what I have to do.
Yeah,
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihlus will accompany you to observe the mission.
Yeah, let's just do
just
this.
Just give the word, Captain.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got
oh,
a problem.
Oh, we got a problem.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden Prime, sir. You better see this.
Bring it up on screen.
Keith David, another great voice actor.
Get down!
Out after that, no comm traffic at all. Just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse shit went down. I like how he has the exact time down. Ooh, little flappy face.
Status report.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet.
It's not so
invisible
anymore.
This mission just got a lot more complicated.
You don't say.
A small strike team can move quickly without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You're going in.
Engaging stealth systems. Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
Your team's the muscle in this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihlus, you coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
And then he just jumps out of the ship.
Nihlus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
Ready and able, sir.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck!
We are approaching drop point two.
And then we magically just get on the ground, because that fall would kill anyone. I don't want to holster my weapon. That looks like something I can check. Ooh, that's not good. That was a grenade, probably. Yep. Okay, good to know. R is grenade. There's the path. Good question, Jenkins. What did happen here? Charred bodies. It's a floaty drone. He's gonna... Jenkins, you just know it. With a name like Jenkins, you're bound to die.
I've lost shield.
Oh, I gained a level. Yay. Plus one there. Plus one there. Let's see, what else? I don't give a shit about pistols. Increased damage is always good. Poor Jenkins.
Rip right through his shields. We're out of chance.
His abilities being hit, that's hilarious.
Sometimes Marines die. The rest of us just have to carry on. We still have to find that beacon.
Aye, aye, sir.
Yeah, suck it, Jenkins. I can't do shit for you. You probably didn't deserve to die, but... You also didn't help your case, slash cause, by... Whoop.
I've got some burned out buildings here, Shepard. Lot of bodies. I'm gonna check it out. I'll try to catch up with you at the dig site.
You do that.
Engaging target!
Thank you. That's super slow paced in this. But it's a lot of fun, I think. Womp. Whoa! Yeah, I'd run from that too.
Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, sir?
Give me a status report, Williams.
Oh, man. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit.
Of course
hit.
She has, like, stereotypical
we tried to get off a distress
female
call,
armor.
They cut off our communications.
Look, I have boobs,
I've
didn't
been fighting
you know?
For my life ever since.
Where's the rest of your squad?
We tried to double back to the beacon, but we walked into an ambush. I don't think any of the others... I think I'm the only one left.
This isn't your fault, Williams. You couldn't have done anything to save them.
Yes, sir. We held our position as long as we could, until the Geth overwhelmed us.
Oh, the Geth.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
You're coming with us, Williams. We need that beacon.
Aye, aye, sir.
Let's do it.
Payback.
Oh, payback. Maybe you can get your eyes to unglitch, too. She has such a lazy-ass eye, it seems like. More accuracy, more damage. Oh, hell yeah. That's not even a choice, is it? Let's do this.
The beacon's at the far end of this trench.
That's good for Caden. baby dad.
You were good, Commander.
Not really enticing in any way, shape, or form, is it? I get to the level up screen is beyond me sometimes. Pause menu perhaps? Yeah, squad. Alright, three more points. Get one to soldier, one to assault training. Combat armor. We can get Caden with Sentinel and Throw, and Ashley gets double soldier, assault training combat armor, and double assault rifle. Alright. Going to find the beacon. Continue to the dig site. Jenkins is dead. No assignments. Save just because it's been a while since make a never since I saved. Alright, moving forward. Ooh, things to look at. Investigating the site.
This is the dig site. The beacon was right here. It must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
Why any survivors is even an option is beyond me. Let's
go. We make for the camp.
It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
Let's do it.
Change of plans, Shepard. There's a small spaceport up ahead. I want to check it out. I'll wait for you there.
Okay, Nihilus. How do I run, though? I'm gonna find sprint in my control. Sprint. Dewey storm. Shift. Toggle movement speed. Z. Is something assigned to Alt currently? Because I could really use something. Toggle movement speed, where'd you go? See how it works with left Alt.
Looks like they hit the camp hard.
It's a good place for an ambush. Keep your guard up.
They're just like highlighting those things. Oh.
Oh god, they're still alive!
What did the Geth do to them?
They turned them into thangs. It's on fire currently.
Check your targets. Could be friendlies.
I seriously keep forgetting that.
Area secure.
Silly little override decryption game, but alright, taking stuff. Taking people's stuff. Taking their stuff. Because they don't need their stuff.
Humans.
Humans!
Hurry.
Would have been better if she'd done, like, a robot voice. Or not robot. Zoidberg.
How did you end up in this shit?
Humans! We hit during the attack. They must have come here for the beacon.
No shit.
Luckily, it wasn't here. It was moved to the spaceport earlier this morning. Manuel and I
stayed
to pack up the camp. When the attack came, the Marines held them off long enough for us to hide. They gave their lives to save us.
No one is saved. The age of humanity is ended.
That dude
Soon,
is...
only ruin and corpses will remain.
That's what he's talking
What's
about.
Wrong with your assistant?
Yeah, what is wrong
Manuel
with him?
Manuel has a brilliant mind, but he's always been a bit unstable. Genius and madness are two sides of the same coin.
Is it madness to see the future? To see the destruction rushing towards us? To understand there is no escape? No hope? No. I am not mad. I'm the only sane one left.
I gave him an extra dose of his meds after the attack.
Say goodnight, Manuel.
You cannot silence the truth. My voice must be heard.
My God! What did you do?
That might have been a little extreme, Commander.
You can't just go around whacking people in the head.
It was only a matter of time until he did something crazy and dangerous.
I suppose you're right. By the time he wakes up, the meds will have kicked in.
Exactly.
Williams, take us to
But
the
I just disrespected someone with
Good
mental
luck,
health
Commander.
Problems. And that's hard. He's just on the floor. God damn.
Yes? Is there something you
No,
need?
I don't need shit
We better
you.
Get moving.
Yeah.
Good luck, Commander.
Thank you. Random space lady. That's actually not bad as a replacement. More damage is good. It's a shotgun, it doesn't need accuracy. Alright. Nope. Let's save. Eden Prime. Archibald. Nihilus. Oh, that's a great time to put that on the screen.
Saren. Nihilus. This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this one.
I wasn't expecting to find the Geth here. The situation's bad.
Don't worry. I've got it under control.
Oh, shit. Damn. always try to micro me. And then I get it, I'm the main protagonist, and the game's coding is kind of designed. Most games' coding. Excuse me. Most games' coding will kind of, you know, place the player in enemy crosshairs first. This game is particularly good at it.
Commander.
Oh, Nihilus. He died. He very much
Torian.
Died.
You know him?
Yeah, we do. He was a homeboy.
He's a Spectre. He was with us on the norm.
Something's moving over behind those crates.
Is it people?
Wait, don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
You need to be more careful.
Sneaking up on us like that nearly got you killed.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Powell. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
What the hell are you talking about?
The other one.
There were two Turians here. Your friend and another one he called Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
We were told a Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened to it?
It's over on the other platform. Probably where that guy's... I knew that beacon was trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone. If I hadn't been behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
How come you're the only one who survived? Why didn't anyone else try to hide behind the crates?
They never had a chance. I was already behind the crates when the attack started.
Wait a minute. You were hiding behind the crates before the attack?
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find me.
What a piece of crap.
You survived because you're lazy?
You make me sick.
You ditch work. Then you cower back here and do nothing while the Geth butcher everyone else.
I don't even have a gun. I couldn't save them. Nobody could. It was horrible.
Oh, Powell.
We need to find that beacon before it's too late.
You're right, we do.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
Where are you gonna go, bruh? The way he walks when he crouches is hilarious.
Yeah.
ahead, I'm moving ahead. Everything is slow, I'm moving ahead. Alright, train controls. Activate. Go-go gadget,
zip the charges. Fans. Destroy the entire colony. Leave no evidence that we were here.
Well, he's a cheery fellow. That's Saren. FYI, if people weren't already aware of the fact, Saren is basically the only bad guy in this game. Until the end, and then you're made aware. Aware of what, I won't say. Time to disarm some bombs. Bombs. Oh, suspense.
Demolition charges. The Geth must have planted them.
Hurry! We need to find them all and shut them down.
Music surges. Oh. Wonder Caden's dying. He's taking rocket shots right to the face. Oh, not what I wanted. That's not the weapon I chose. Come on. Is Caden gonna get back up? Or is he gonna stay on the ground? Dead. It's a bomb. So much time remaining, I can check shit out. Like this crate. Where there's stuff. I like stuff. Yeah. Disarmed those charges. Sniper rifle. Just lose the combat sensor. The hurricane. Medium armor. It's exactly the same. Does it look any better? No, I like the N7 stuff for now. I could probably give this to Ashley, and she'll get a boost out of it. She'll get damage protection, but not tech biotic. Caden can't use it. Oh well. You learn about games like this is you check every nook and cranny for things before you move on to the next section of the mission. Otherwise, you just lose out on free gear. Ah. Well, I'm sorry. The override failed. It won't. Boom. That's what I'm talking about. XP, money, stuff. I like stuff. The other thing BioWare does really well with these games is the little mini decryption puzzles and things of that nature. Are really interesting, really fun. Always provide some kind of level of thinking to it. It's not just, you know, an empty exercise for the most part. The edge. Alright. Well, let's go see. Nothing over there. Prothean beacon time. Investigate.
Normandy, the beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up. Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
Like, Saren, perhaps? Her eyes! Oh my god, they get... Oh no, what am I doing to myself?
Shepard!
It's Archibald! It's Archibald, damn it! I blew it up with my brain. With my brain. Meanwhile, on the space squid.
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a human alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
This human must be eliminated.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. I'm supposed to be eliminated. Oh, wow.
Doctor! Dr. Chakwas! I think he's waking up.
Dr. Chakwas. She has a funny name. She's a funny lady. I think she likes to get drunk a lot more than she should.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Like hell.
Like the morning after shore leave. How long was I out?
A few days.
About 15 hours. Oh. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
Where's the beacon now? What happened to it?
It got exploded.
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. The lieutenant and I carried you back here to the ship.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity.
My brain's all
abnormal
weird.
Beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
Not a dream.
I saw...
a vision.
I'm not sure what I saw. Death? Destruction? Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report.
No shit.
Oh, Captain Anderson.
How's our XO holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I tell the commander's going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
I'm pissed off about
Intel the
cat.
Dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were talking about down there. That's why things went to hell.
Yeah, that's why things went to hell.
We haven't been outside the Veil in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
The tonal switches are a little disconcerting sometimes.
Things look bad.
Yeah, Nihlus is dead.
Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
The Geth would have wiped out the whole colony if I hadn't stopped them.
Yeah.
I'll stand behind you and your group. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here.
Ooh, it's Saren.
It's Saren. That other Turian. Saren's a specter. One of the best. A living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue.
A rogue specter.
A rogue specter's trouble. Saren's dangerous. And he hates humans.
Why?
Yeah, why?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy. A lot of aliens think that way. Most of them don't do anything about it. But Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how...
I mean, you're assuming that. One direction is not an alliance.
With that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
It was a crazy-ass LSD dream, bro.
A vision? A vision of what?
War.
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
What are we gonna tell them? I had a bad dream?
Yeah, sassy.
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation, his politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war.
Ooh,
he has
man war.
From the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
Not if I can help it.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that easy. He's a specter. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
So.
We prove Saren's gone rogue, and the Council will revoke his Spectre status.
I'll contact the Ambassador, and see if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel.
Yeah.
We should be getting close.
Citadel's a dope.
Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Now I'm in my regular fatigues. Mosey about the ship. Wait, I like how he leans into all his turns. It's a little ridiculous in my Voicing all opinion.
Hey,
Commander. Hey, Ashley.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. The crew could use some good news after what happened to Jenkins.
He'll be missed.
Jenkins was a valuable part of this crew.
Part of me feels guilty over what happened. If Jenkins was still alive, I might not be here.
Oh, come on.
You're a good soldier, Williams. You belong on the Normandy.
Thanks, Commander. I appreciate that.
Things were pretty rough down there. Are you okay?
The relationship dynamics are really interesting.
I've seen friends die before. Comes with being a Marine. But to see my whole unit
wiped out.
And you never get used to seeing dead civilians. But things would have been a lot worse if you hadn't shown up.
We couldn't have done it without you, Williams.
Probably could have, but
thanks,
it's okay.
Commander. I have to admit, I was a little worried about being assigned to the Normandy. It's nice when someone makes you feel welcome.
I think you're gonna fit in here just fine, Williams.
Thanks, Commander.
I wouldn't call those Paragon points, necessarily.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
No, I don't.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Peace. So you can start relationships like every other member of the crew, but you can't get one with Dr. Jacquez. That's the real error in this game. Dr. Jacquez needs to be all up on it. She a dog. Sassy old bird. Alright. I don't need the elevator. I can go to the bridge all on my own. Thank you very much. Yeah, galaxy map. Only the commanding officer. Well. Yeah.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. Losing Jenkins was hard enough on the crew.
What am I supposed to do right now? Hammer. Alright, journal. Speak to Joker. Have a level up, though. Go. Soldier, assault rifle, assault training. Then we'll get fitness. I'll start getting super tanky. Archibald. Made enough of those corrections.
Good timing, Commander. I was just about to bring us into the Citadel.
People can call me by the title.
Spare money at work.
Anytime they call me Shepherd, I'll go, Archibald. Bit of a ridiculous structure, but it's very cool once you actually land on it.
Look at the size of this
yeah,
ship.
It's fucking huge. Flagship. Oh, they're talking about the Ascension.
Well, size isn't everything.
Why so touchy, Joker?
I'm just saying, you need firepower too.
Yeah,
look,
but size usually implies firepower.
Could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy, requesting permission to land.
Stand by for clearance, Normandy. Clearance granted. You may begin your approach. Transferring you to an Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower. Normandy out.
Normandy, this is Alliance Tower. Please proceed to Dock 422.
Cool the first few times, but when they make you do it over and over again, the waiting load times get a little annoying.
This is an outrage!
Outrage!
The Council would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony!
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Saren? You can't just ignore a rogue Spectre. I demand action!
You don't get to make demands of a Council, Ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
Citadel Security
is
ineffective,
Anderson. I see you brought half your crew with you.
Just the ground team from Eden Prime, in case you had any questions.
I have the mission reports. I assume they're accurate?
They are.
Dina.
Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
Saren's a threat to every human colony out there. If they don't stop him, I will.
He gets very,
settle
like,
down, Commander. You've
man
already
of action-y.
Done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres. The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead, Nihilus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
That's Saren's fault, not his.
Then we better hope the CSEC investigation turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres.
Well, those bastards.
Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
Her eyes are a little bit more...
And that's why I hate
there they go. Now we look at everything. Boom. It's a game that really takes to heart the idea of exploration. That's what I'm looking forward to with Andromeda again. Yeah. Fighting, exploration, diplomacy. It's a real role-playing game you play.
Hello there, human.
Hello there, human.
Sincere apology. But I am here on business and cannot be distracted right now.
You seem distressed. Is there something I can do to help?
Alarmed response. You overheard that, did you? This is all going so wrong. And it is the Asari consort's fault. She's the one who started all this.
Oh my.
Who's this Asari consort?
Yeah.
Curious. You have not heard. You must be new to the Citadel. Everyone knows Shaira, the consort. I cannot speak more about this problem. It is too sensitive. Suffice it to say, she has compromised my authority as a diplomat.
Well, that's unfortunate for him.
Where can I find this Asari consort?
She's across the bridge from here. Her offices are easy enough to spot. Good day, human.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Earth Clan, you are in the wrong place, I think. Your ambassador is next door in the large office.
Chastising remark. Don't be so rude, Dan. At least introduce yourself.
I am Din Korlak, Volus Ambassador. Is there something I can do for you, Earth Clan?
You seem to have a bit of a chip on your shoulder, Din.
You humans are new to the Citadel, and yet the Council has granted you great favor.
Chastising rebuke, Din. Your species has always been granted many concessions. Volus territory has expanded tenfold since coming to the Citadel.
He should be happy then.
Details. We still have no real say in decisions that affect Citadel space.
Goodbye, Ambassador.
Peace out, motherfucker.
Yes. Good day, Earth Clan.
Earth Clan. That's the other problem I had. And these are all minor ticks for me. The fact that you get stuck jogging a lot of places.
Greetings, and welcome to the Presidium. My name is Avena, and I am pleased to be your virtual guide throughout this level of the city.
What does that mean?
I am a fully I may also be contacted through any of the Presidium VI terminals.
Sounds interesting, yeah.
Should you require...
Give me the tour.
You are standing on the far end of this level. You can see the Citadel Tower, where the Council meets regularly
Peace
to discuss
out.
Matters of interstellar importance.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, and thank you for using Avena. Please enjoy your visit to the Citadel.
I will.
Good day, Commander. The human ambassador is up the stairs, first room on the right.
I should be going now.
Have a pleasant day.
I will. But also, don't tell me what to do. To the tower. Is this where I mean? Yeah.
Saren's hiding something. Give me more time. Stall them.
Stall the council? Don't be ridiculous. Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Garrus. He's my favorite character in this whole fucking thing. Turians are such weird bastards. Garrus Vakarian.
I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
Sounds like you really want to bring him down.
I don't trust him. Something about him rubs me the wrong way.
Garrus is the best.
Everything he touches is classified. I can't find any hard evidence.
I think the Council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard. Maybe they'll listen to you.
No, they probably won't, though, bro. But it's okay. Thanks for trying. We'll become homies very soon, and I look forward to it. Caden gets tossed in like 2 quick seconds. A lot of wandering to do. No, I'm good. I just wanted to be able to have that as an option. Walking upstairs, doing it slow. Hey, there's Captain Anderson.
Harry's already started, come on.
Oh, see, I hate it when they start things without me.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern, but there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
An eyewitness saw him kill Nihilus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
What?
I resent these accusations. Nihilus was a fellow Spectre, and a friend.
That just let you catch him off guard.
Captain Anderson, you always seem to be involved when humanity makes false charges against me. And this must be your protege, Commander Shepard.
Isn't that already disconcerting enough?
Destroyed.
You're the one who destroyed the beacon. Then you tried to cover it up.
Shift the blame to cover your own failures. Just like Captain
He's
Anderson.
Got, like, shit coming out of his leg. That's not
what
natural.
Did you expect?
Normal Turians don't have that.
Saren despises humanity. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
That's not what that
your
response
species
was there.
Needs to learn its place, Shepard. You're not ready to join the Council. You're not even ready to join the Spectres.
He has no right to say that! That's not his decision!
Shepard's admission into the Spectres is not the purpose of this meeting.
That's very
this
true.
Meeting has no purpose. The humans are wasting your time, Counselor. And mine.
You can't hide behind the Council forever.
There is still one outstanding issue. Commander Shepard's vision. It may
and
have been
then we get all,
beacon.
Like, woogie.
Are we allowing dreams into evidence
yeah.
now? How can I defend my innocence against this kind of testimony?
I agree. Our judgment must be based on facts and evidence, not wild imaginings and reckless speculation.
Do you have anything else to add, Commander Shepard?
You've made your decision. I won't waste my breath.
The Council has found no evidence of any connection between Saren and the Geth. Ambassador, Your petition to have him disbarred from the Spectres is denied.
I'm glad to see justice was served.
This meeting is adjourned.
It was a mistake bringing you into that hearing, Captain. You and Saren have too much history. It made the Council question our motives.
I know Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race. Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
Tell me about this history between you and Saren.
Yeah, let's get into it.
I worked with him on a mission a long time ago.
I like how he turns away.
Things went bad. Real bad. We shouldn't talk about this here. But I know what he's like. And he has to be stopped.
What's our next step?
As a Spectre, he's virtually...
I read the novel that covered that thing that they're talking about with Anderson.
What about Garrus?
It's like a human colony gets...
We saw him arguing with the executive.
...slaughtered.
That's right.
Or some shit like that.
For
I forget
more time
exactly what.
His report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
Any idea where we could find him?
Garrus.
I have a contact in CSEC who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the job. I won't waste my time with that loser.
You won't have to. I don't want the Council using your past history with Saren as an excuse to ignore anything we turn up. Shepard will handle this.
I'll take care of it.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
Harkin's probably getting drunk at Cora's. It's a dingy little club in the lower section of the wards.
I thought you said he was a drunken loser.
Couldn't hurt to go talk to him. Just be careful.
Quick turnaround.
Call him reliable.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
Let's dig it.
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge.
He's a terrorist.
I was working
cell,
with Saren
right.
to find and remove a known terrorist threat. Saren eliminated his target, but a lot of people died along the way. Innocent people. And the official records just covered it all up. But I saw how he operates. No conscience. No hesitation. He'd kill 1,000 innocent civilians to end a war without a second thought.
I should go.
I'm not going to say
luck,
anything.
Shepard. I'll be over in the ambassador's office if you need anything else.
Another fun fact, this is the final battle zone. It's super annoying. Worst environment to fight in, I think I've ever had. And oh, something's interesting. What's interesting, Caden?
You sure have to climb a lot of stairs to reach the council. I think that's supposed to be symbolic of the...
That guy's up to something.
What? Oh, no, I wasn't. Never mind.
What?
Yes, is there something you want?
Why are you so interested in the Keepers?
Keepers? I've got no interest in the Keep...
Don't get coy. I know what I saw.
I'm not so sure I should be talking to you about this.
We're just talking. Is there something wrong with that?
Yeah, is there?
No.
Oh my god, yeah.
I guess it wouldn't hurt to tell you. I'm using a small scanner to gather readings on the Keepers. So far I've had mixed results. I find it difficult to get near the creatures.
Why were you being so secretive about it, though?
Yeah, man.
Well, technically, we're not supposed to disturb the Keepers. I don't really think my scanning disturbs them, but the authorities might disagree. I'd like to do it more openly, but it's not really worth getting arrested over.
I'm sure it isn't.
I could help you out. I'm not worried about the authorities.
I don't even know who you are.
I'm Commander Shepard, with the Alliance Military.
Hmm. Well, I suppose I could use the help. You'll need this. It's the scanning device I developed. Activated each time you see a Keeper. All collected data will automatically upload to my database. I'll even send a few credits your way for each unique scan.
I should get going then.
Yes, I have much work myself.
Yes. Yeah.
So long, and good luck with the scanning.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Scan. Ooh, pulling out my guns. Unexpected. I don't remember being able to do this. What? Never used to let you just pull your gun out. Maybe that was the Xbox version when I first played this game ages ago. I'm being so intrigued by it because it was like,
I can't believe the council ignored all the evidence.
Oh, I can't believe it. Yeah, I can. Welcome to government, lady. Bureaucracy.
Oh, so now we just chase leads while this smug Turian runs around with his geth
trees. Yeah. Anyways, I remember the feeling I had of just, like, sheer wonder at this game. Because it's so immaculately crafted in terms of, like, the depth that they put into it. You know, there are points that I would change. The amount of slow time.
Look at that bug thing.
Please do not disturb the keepers.
I won't. God. Or will I?
Hanar refuses to listen to reason. Why can't it act in an orderly and lawful manner?
Are there laws being broken here?
I am not unreasonable. The Hanar is free to spew its nonsense once it purchases an evangelical permit.
If you'd like, I could talk to the Hanar for you.
I have argued with the stubborn jelly all after.
Do you desire to learn of the Enkindlers? Or has the Honorable CSEC officer enlisted assistance?
Is this really how you want to represent the Enkindlers?
The truth of the Enkindlers must be made known. They gave the Hanar language, and gave the universe the mass relays. This one only wishes to spread the truth to any who will listen. There is no intent to cause trouble.
What if I purchase the evangelical permit for you?
Finances are only a partial limitation. This one does not believe that one should pay in order to speak the truth.
That one is right, but it's religion.
However, this one also does not possess the 150 credits necessary to purchase the permit.
150 credits? This should cover you.
This is a most appreciated action. You are not of the Hanar, but you wish to help spread the truth of the Enkindlers. This one will not cause any further trouble for the CSEC officer. This one offers its thanks.
I see the Hanar is left. Thank you.
Happy to help.
Here, for your assistance in this matter. Now, if you'll excuse me, I should report to my superiors.
It's probably going to give me, like, 200 or something. Metagel? Seriously? Lame. Quick save. And also level up. I'm pretty sure I have one. One sentinel point. One decryption point. Archibald. Ah, oh, he's no points. Ashley does, though. Assault training. Combat armor. Alright. Anything else, I can't shoot people. Hopefully it'll get me to sprint faster. No. Kind of, actually. Seasick? You know.
In light of the recent attack on Eden Prime, many colonial investors are pulling their support for future projects.
Oh, no.
Proponents of expanded human colonization insist that Eden Prime was an isolated case. Nevertheless, colonist enrollment has dropped sharply. Many colonial proposals are on hold until backers have some reassurance that human colonies will be adequately protected.
But there's no guarantees. There's no guarantees that human colonies will be safe. Whatever will we do? Now I have those options. The docking bay. Quick, let's find Garrus. Is he here? No, this is the requisitions officer.
One sec. Looking you up.
Yeah, look me up, motherfucker.
Commander Shepard, here with the Alliance military. First time on the Citadel, that about right?
How did you know all that?
I'm the CSEC requisitions officer. I need to make sure our buyers are authorized. So, will you be purchasing anything today, Commander Shepard?
Yes, I will.
Show me what you've got.
Excellent. I hope you find what you're looking for.
But I got no kind of money. Selling. Is that not currently my mission? That's where I'm going to Korra's den. Because what's his name is there? Harkin. Joy of all joys. A gentleman's club. Yes.
That's him.
Oh!
Fist told us to take you down if you showed up. What are you waiting for? I'm standing right here. This is Fist's only chance. If he swallows. smart he'll take it. He's not coming out, Rex. End of story. This story is just beginning.
Statement could not be any more true.
I have no quarrel with you.
What was that all about?
Who knows? Let's just try not to get caught in the middle.
Rex is dope, though.
Alliance military. I could have been a Marine, you know. Instead, I joined the goddamn Citadel Security. Biggest mistake of my life.
I'm looking for a CSEC officer, a Turian named Garrus.
Garrus? You must be one of Captain Anderson's crew. You're a bastard still trying to bring Saren down, eh? I know where Garrus is, but you gotta tell me something first. Did the captain let you in on his big secret?
Don't waste my time.
Garrus is before this gets ugly.
But it's all related, don't you see? The captain used to be a Spectre. Didn't know that, did you? It was all very hush-hush. The first human ever given that honor. And then he blew it. Screwed up his mission so bad they kicked him out. Of course, he blames Saren. Says the Turians set him up.
Why'd they kick him out?
I'll ask him. I never heard any of the details. Bet it's a good story, though. The heroes fall.
The book proves that Saren did everything. I mean,
just tell me where
really
Garrus
had to question that.
Garrus was sniffing around Dr. Michelle's office. She runs the med clinic on the other side of
Dr.
the
Dr. Michelle.
Unless I heard he was going back there.
I'm out of here.
Dr. Michelle. Level up. 3 points. One for assault training, because I get fitness. One for fitness. And one to pistols, because I hate that I have to get the shotguns with pistols. And like sniper rifle. Well, that explains why I'm so wobbly, I would imagine.
The back rooms are private, reserved for Fist and his friends.
Who's Fist?
He owns this club, but the customers have to stay out front.
What did that other Krogan want? Rex?
Personal matter.
Not real chatty, is he?
Goodbye.
Enjoy the club.
I will. And so much is that I won't die walking out the door this time.
An ass. Bet he's just messing with our heads.
No, Harkin's not an ass. Although I think, if memory serves, Anderson wasn't officially a Spectre. It was the same kind of mission that we just went through, and he gets shafted. To the med clinic.
I didn't tell anyone.
Oh my.
I swear.
That was smart, Doc. Now if Garrus comes around, you stay smart. Keep your mouth shut or we'll... Who are you? Let her go.
Garrus is a homeboy. Fucking puts one shot in that dude's head in like 2 seconds. Thanks for the distraction. Is that what he's gonna say? Whoop. They're all just hiding. beat down.
Perimeter clear.
Yes.
Perfect timing, Shepard. Gave me a clear shot at that bastard.
You took him down clean.
Yes, sometimes you get lucky. Dr. Michelle, are you hurt?
No, I'm okay. Thanks to you, all of you.
Why were they threatening you?
Yeah.
Who do they work for?
They work for Feast.
Feast.
They wanted to shut me up, keep me from telling Garrus about the Quarian.
What Quarian?
A few days ago,
Tali.
A Quarian came by my office. She'd been shot, but she wouldn't tell me who did it. I could tell she was scared, probably on the run. She asked me about the Shadow Broker. She wanted to trade information in exchange for a safe place to hide.
Then what?
I put her in contact with Fist. He's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
Not anymore. Now he works for Saren. The Shadow Broker isn't too happy.
I'm sure the Shadow Broker is displeased.
Trade the Shadow Broker? That's stupid, even for him. Saren must have made him quite the offer.
Don't
the
die.
Must have something Saren wants. Something worth crossing the Shadow Broker to get.
What else can you tell me about the Quarian?
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Like I said, she wanted to trade information for a place to hide. She didn't... Wait a minute. Geth. Her information had something to do with the Geth.
She must be able to link Saren to the Geth. There is no way the Council can ignore this.
Time we paid Fist a visit.
This is your show, Shepard. But I want to bring Saren down as much as you do. I'm coming with you.
Welcome aboard, Garrus.
I love Garrus.
You know, we aren't the only ones going after Fist. The Shadow Broker hired a Krogan bounty hunter named Rex to take him out.
Yeah, we saw him in the bar.
A Krogan might come in handy.
Yeah.
Last I heard, he was at the CSEC Academy.
What's he doing there?
Fist accused him of making threats. We brought Rex in for a little talk.
Move out. If you...
Obviously Garrus. Yeah. I like the all-alien squad. The Garrus-Rex squad, eventually. I do need to equip Garrus with the proper weaponry. Minimal damage to... That's before over. Interesting. Toxic rounds, my faves. To CSEC Academy. CSEC. I forgot how much I loved this game. It's a little grainy on the edges. But not in the worst way possible. Rex.
Witnesses saw you making threats in Fist's bar. Stay away from him.
I don't take orders from you.
Yeah, you don't. You really don't.
You should warn Fist. I will kill him.
You want me to arrest you?
I want you to try.
I do want you to try. Oh, God. Fucking A, Rex.
Go on. Get out of here.
Do I know you, human?
My name's Shepard. I'm going after Fist. Thought you might want to come along.
I love it. He's so human.
Shepard. Commander Shepard. I've heard a lot about you. We're both warriors, Shepard. Out of respect, I'll give you fair warning. I'm going to kill Fist.
Fist knows you're coming. We'll have a better chance if we all work together.
My people have a saying. Seek the enemy of your enemy, and you will find a friend.
I think we're gonna get along just fine, Rex.
Let's go. I hate to keep Fist waiting.
Erdnot Rex and Garrus Vakarian. My homeboys. For Evzies. Archibald nails. All right, homies, shall we? Oh, duh. Squad up, terrain agent, give him tactical armor, give him assault rifles. Save, because when you get two new homies in the span of about 10 minutes, you really need to save. Let's go kill some fools. That was a quick load time. Alright, now it's where the real fun begins.
Looks like it shut down.
Yeah.
This knows we're coming.
Take him out! Oh, shit!
Poison damage is really helpful. Melted him. Damn it. Ah. Scimitar. Two. Reaper two. Horrible accuracy rating. That's my real problem. All these. Or not give him. Garrus. Marginal.
Surrender.
Yeah. Tell me where the Quarian is, and I won't have to shoot you in the kneecap.
I don't know where she is. That's the truth.
He's no use to you now. Let me kill him.
Wait. I don't know where the Quarian is, but I know where you can find her. The Quarian isn't here. Said you'd only deal with the Shadow Broker himself.
Face to face? Impossible. Even I was hired through an agent.
Nobody meets the Shadow Broker, ever. Even I don't know his true identity. But she didn't know that. I told her I'd set a meeting up. But when she shows up, it'll be Saren's men waiting for her.
Tell me where that meeting is before I blow your lying head up.
Yes.
Here on the wards, the back alley by the markets.
What are you doing?
The Shadow Broker paid me to kill him. I don't leave jobs half done.
A lot of people died because of him. He had it coming. Now let's move. We have to save that Quarian.
So, like, it's 1980s in a way.
bring it?
Where's the Shadow Broker? Where's Fist?
They'll be here. Where's the evidence?
No way. The deal's off.
She's crafty.
Fist set me up. I knew I couldn't trust him.
Don't worry about Fist. He got what was coming to him.
Then I guess there are two things I need to thank you for. Who are you?
My name's Shepard. I'm looking for evidence.
Then I have a chance to repay you for saving my life. But not here.
We could take her to the human embassy.
Yes, let's.
You're not making my life easy, Shepard. Firefights in the wards, an all-out assault on Korra's den. Do you know how many... Who's this? A Quarian? What are you up to, Shepard?
This Quarian can help us bring down Saren. I would have told you that if you hadn't jumped down my throat.
I apologize, Commander. This whole thing with Saren has me right on edge. Maybe we should just start at the beginning, Miss...
My name is Tali. Tali Zora Naraya.
We don't see many Quarians here. Why did you leave the flotilla?
I was on my pilgrimage. My rite of passage into adulthood.
Tell us what you found.
During my travels, I began hearing reports of Geth.
They're basically like alien Amish
people. Into exile, the Geth have never ventured beyond the Veil. I was curious. I tracked a patrol of Geth to an uncharted world. I waited for one to become separated from its unit. Then I disabled it and removed its memory core.
I thought the Geth fried their memory cores when they died. Some kind of defense mechanism.
What did you find out?
Most of the core was wiped clean, but I salvaged something from its audio banks.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
Ooh.
That's Saren's voice. This proves he was involved in the attack.
Saren won't get out of this one.
Wait, there's more. Saren wasn't working alone.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
I don't recognize that other voice, the one talking about Reapers.
I feel like I've heard that name before.
According to the Memory Core, the Reapers were a hyper-advanced machine race that existed 50,000 years ago. The Reapers hunted the Protheans to total extinction, and then they vanished. At least, that's what the Geth believe.
Sounds a little far-fetched.
The vision on Eden Prime. I understand.
Yeah, he gets all, like, pretend sweaty.
I saw the Protheans being wiped out by the Reapers.
The Geth revere the Reapers as gods, the pinnacle of non-organic life. And they believe Saren knows how to bring the Reapers back.
The Council is just going to love this.
This is a lot to handle. They might just ignore everything we tell them.
No matter what they think about the rest of this, those audio files prove Saren's a traitor.
The Captain's right. We need to present this to the Council right away.
What about her? The Quarian?
My name is Tali. You saw me in the alley, Commander. You know what I can do. Let me come with you.
I'll take all the help I can get.
Thanks. You won't regret this.
Anderson and I will go ahead to get things ready with the Council. Take a few minutes to collect it.
Yeah, the Erdnot Garrus squad is still my best. Alright, let's see. Need to start getting out of the Citadel and actually exploring the galaxy.
which I think will actually start to happen with when we expose Saren as a traitor.
Excuse me, Commander Shepard. Commander Shepard, my name is Samesh Bhatia. Forgive the intrusion, but I have nowhere else to turn.
A lot of people want my help these days.
My wife was a Marine.
It's kind of
she was in the 212 on Eden. I've requested that my wife's body be returned to me for cremation, but the military has refused my request.
Why did they refuse your request?
I don't know. All I know is that they have declared it impossible for my wife to be returned to me.
We'll look into it.
The man in charge of my case is Mr. Bosker. Thank you for your time. I just want to...
The only problem is that dude has no idea that his wife is probably a Geth husk.
There was only darkness. The enkindlers gave light.
That's funny. No one to talk to. Barlavon.
What's this? One of the Earth Clan. You were at Torfin, correct? You led the final assault against the enemy base, if memory serves.
You've got me at a disadvantage here.
Forgive me, Earth Clan. My name is Barlavon. My job makes it necessary for me to keep informed. I am a financial advisor to many important clients here on the Citadel. When someone as important as yourself arrives on the station, I take notice.
Tell me more about your job.
Galactic finance is incredible. I'm an expert in how... I also offer premium services for those clients who need someone to conduct business without drawing unwanted attention. Discreet.
Sounds pretty shady.
Everything I do falls completely with a... For example, even if his true motives were to help his people, he would be accused of advancing the petition for his own personal gain. I can keep his personal finances private.
Still sounds shady to me.
Then you can only hope you will never be cursed with a large enough fortune to require my services.
Tell me more about the shadow.
Most people think I deal in finances, but my real currency is knowledge. But the Shadow Broker is the true master. Every day he buys and sells secrets that could topple governments, always giving them to the highest bidder. Yet somehow he never seems to upset the natural balance of power. All those secrets being passed around seem to even out. Nobody ends up with an advantage in the end.
Any guess what his identity
might
be?
I don't know. Nobody does. The Shadow Broker. How else could they juggle so many contacts at the same time? How else could they keep all that information from getting crossed? But they've got the perfect setup. Every government is forced to play their game so they don't get behind. But no matter how long you play, no matter how many secrets you buy, you can never win.
Ooh.
I thought you'd know more about the man you work for.
From time to time I come across information I sell. The more you know, the more dangerous the game becomes. I don't like danger, Commander. I'll leave that to you.
I should go.
Yes, I should.
Goodbye, Commander.
Goodbye, Barlavon.
Ah, human. This one is greatly pleased.
Who are you?
This one's face name is Delaninder. though many in this place simply refer to it as Delon. Please take time to examine the fine goods it has for purchase.
Show me your items.
Oh, this one is pleased to do so, human. You will not be disappointed.
So fucking creepy. Oh, this one is pleased. Yeah, pleased. Ugh. Oh well. Eventually I'll start getting more money. Keeper. Yeah, money. Give me some money.
Welcome. I am Nelina. Would you like me to see when the consort will be able to meet with you?
Can't I just go in?
I'm afraid not. But if you wish to leave your name, she'll make every effort to meet with you.
Commander Shepard.
Excellent. You should hear something in 3 or 4 months.
Nobody's worth that much of a wait.
Well, that's not for me to judge. I have your name, and you'll be contacted. Is there
what is the consort? What does she do?
What does she do?
It's difficult to explain. Some seek her for advice. Most of the time, our clients won't realize what they were seeking until after she has provided it for them.
You make her sound like some kind of oracle.
No, not in the... I suggest you make an appointment and see for yourself.
I think I'm done here.
Oh, well, I hope you'll return.
Nelina.
Yes, Shaira?
Send the commander up to see me. I wish to speak with him.
Yes, of course, mistress.
BioWare gets its, like, pervy nerd on.
Huh. It appears the consort has taken notice of you. She'd like to meet with you now.
Okay.
Where do I go?
Just head upstairs.
Well, I will.
I see even the humans find the consort irresistible.
Welcome. It is a pleasure. You're with the Alliance? My brother's a private back on Earth.
Shaira.
That is close enough, Commander. I've heard a great many things about you since your arrival here in our Citadel.
I don't like people spying on me.
I apologize, Commander. I make it my business to know when important people arrive on the station. Many of them become clients. But that is not why I asked you here. I have a certain problem that could use your expertise.
Tell me about this problem you're having.
Yeah.
I have a friend, Septimus, a retired Turian general. I won't discuss the details, but he wanted me to be more than I could be. We had a falling out. Now he's been... If you would speak to him as a fellow soldier, I believe he will listen to you and let the matter be.
What exactly do you want me to tell him?
Appeal to a sense of honor. If you can convince him to stop spreading lies about
She's
me,
very
I would be very grateful.
Touchy. You're someone I just met.
Now I must ask you to take your leave. I have many clients waiting to see me.
Up the death map, consort's dead. Lol.
I went very often when it would still be our coast.
Yeah, ever since Fisk.
We can go to Chorus Den real quick. Talk to the general. Come back, talk to the to the consort. And then we'll go to the Citadel Tower. Get this puppy. Puppy. Get this show on the road.
Then I'll probably call it for the time being. For no other reason than it's gonna be a busy day.
Commander! What do you want?
I'm here on Chaira's behalf. Your lies are hurting her.
Your
lies have been killing me for days. I've seen a lot of horrible things in my days, and there's only one woman in this damn galaxy that helps me forget it.
This is pathetic. What could a woman do to put you in this state?
Because she rejected me. Me! Septimus Araka, General of the Turian Fleet.
I think I can see why you're upset. But spreading these lies won't make it better.
Yeah, man.
Look, kid, I appreciate what you're trying to do, but don't waste your time.
You need to start acting like a general if you want to beat this.
I spent all my life acting like a general, and what did it get me? Huh? No, those days are over. I'll just be what I am. A tired, lonely, worn-out soldier.
You're a damn general. Quit your whining.
Ha! You got balls, kid. There are only 5 people in this damn galaxy who talk to me like that. So you think it's that easy?
It damn well couldn't hurt.
Maybe you're right, Commander. Shaira's worth the effort. Even if she won't have me back.
Now get up and get moving, General.
All right. I'll go to her. Say, you're a bright kid. Would you be interested in earning a few extra credits?
What do you want me to do?
There's an L-Corps diplomat.
Why is that?
Because I told him. Look, I just need you to convince him of the truth.
Why can't you tell him yourself?
Well, the last time he's... Take this data pad. It shows where I got my info. It will exonerate Shai.
Who am I taking it to?
His name is Zeltan.
Well, exactly.
Here's to soldiers acting like soldiers. Thanks, Commander. You know, you might make a good general yourself one day.
So minutes. So I'll probably just leave the camera rolling. and turn my mic off. And then I'll be back shortly after, you know, get a glass of water, things like that. So I'm gonna save. And be back in a couple minutes. Alright. Sorry for that brief disruption. And we're back. It was a long time ago. Running through the consort's den. After... Oh, I was supposed to go talk to the Elcor diplomat. That's what it was, not the consort's den. Whoa. That wasn't what I was trying to do, but... It's the embassies, if I remember correctly. Hoo-ha! God, y'all. Not there. But here. There he is.
Strained greeting, human. This is
I know who revealed your secret.
Unbelieving. I know this Septimus, and he could not learn my secrets.
Here. This should be proof.
Confused. This is difficult to fathom. If the
Septimus is a powerful
relieved,
man.
I suppose. Startled, anxious request. Please, human.
So long.
Farewell.
Thankful. That was a great thing you did, Commander. Approving.
You did.
You see, Din, not all humans are as you say.
I'm sure the Earth Clan stands to profit from this in some way.
Earth Clan.
Apologetic. Not listen to my wisdom.
I won't. I'm just gonna walk out of the room. Fuck your bolus, compatriot. This little beady head. Completely conjoined to his body. God, my cough is killing me today. No, she's in the Presidium. Consort chambers and seven motherfuckers. So, interesting thing about N7. N stands for Special Forces. We don't really address this ever. To really pour through the lore, the codex. Yeah. See? N7. N is the letter code for Special Forces personnel. 1 to 7. All 26 letters used, but 1 to 7 is the number. Level of experience. So N7 means you're a badass, essentially, is what it means. N7. So all the nerds. Maybe even myself included at some point soon here. You have them are totally
Commander,
out of our depth.
I recently received a lovely note from someone.
A lovely note.
Thank
oh, that's joyous.
Anything. Even the Elcor diplomat has withdrawn his campaign against me.
Let's talk payment. No,
I'm glad I could help.
I'm not going to be a
you
dick
are too
about
kind,
it.
Commander, but I would not expect you
not
to help
women.
Me out of the kindness of your heart. I also have one more thing to give you. If you're interested.
What are you offering me?
I offer a gift of words, an affirmation of who you are and who you will become.
That's such a lame...
I see your skin,
like,
tough as the scales on any Turian, unyielding.
An affirmation.
A wall between you and everyone else, but it protects you, makes you strong. You never hide your strength, either. It serves you well, terrifies your foes.
It should.
Few will dare to stand against you.
Except
this may be who you are, but it is not who you will become.
Ooh.
It only forms the basis for your future greatness. Remember these words when doubt descends, Commander.
Thanks.
Yeah, really. Thanks, I guess.
Close your eyes and relax, Commander.
Oh, now what are we gonna get, Jiggy? Getting jiggy with it? Nah. Oh, yeah. Wow. I totally forgot that that happened. His shipmates just, like, dip out, I guess.
Fuck! Okay. Whoa! Killing it!
Some, like, Titanic shit right
here,
there.
Commander, in light of your efforts with the Elder Master, I would like you to have this small trinket.
A trinket?
What is it?
A small mystery. I have never learned its use or purpose, but I sense it is time for me to pass it on.
Such a bullshit excuse.
And now I must ask you to leave. I have done everything I can for you. Remember my words, Commander Shepard.
Did she give me Metagel?
They will give you strength.
She gave me Metagel? I'm pretty sure that is the most useless trinket, other than the fact that it's going to heal me. How did she not know what it was?
Or is it some random thing that's going to show up in my journal now as, like, an assignment?
No. No, no.
I'm going to do a quick save. For those few people watching, any ridiculousness that occurs is only gravy, I guess. So, where am I going? Might as well go expose Sarum, because there's not a lot else currently that they want me to do, but now I'm gonna get up in this guy's grill and... Oh, that's silly. If they just put it there and put the bench in the other place, that'd make more sense, wouldn't it? You wanted to actually see the council.
Come on, Udina's presenting.
I'm always late to meetings. They like get there, they start without me.
Eden Prime was a major victory.
Oh.
The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit,
and one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
You wanted proof? There it is.
Point defiantly.
This evidence is irrefutable, Ambassador. Saren will be stripped of his Spectre status, and all efforts will be made to bring him in to answer for his crimes.
I recognize the other voice, the one speaking with Saren. Matriarch Benezia.
Benezia?
Who's she?
Matriarchs are powerful Asari who have entered the final stage of their lives. Revered for their wisdom and experience, they serve as guides and mentors to my people. Matriarch Benezia is a powerful biotic, and she had many followers. She will make a formidable ally for Saren.
I'm more interested in the Reapers. What do you know about them?
Only what was extracted from the Geth's memory core. The Reapers were an ancient race of machines that wiped out the Protheans. Then they vanished.
The Geth believe the Reapers are gods, and Saren is the prophet for their return.
Ooh.
We think the conduit is the key to bringing them back. Saren's searching for it. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Do we even know what this conduit is?
Saren thinks it can bring back the Reapers. That's bad enough.
Yeah.
Listen to what you're saying. Saren wants to bring back the machines that wiped out all life in the galaxy?
Well...
Impossible. It has to be.
So
where
what?
Where did the Reapers go? Why did they vanish? How come we found no trace of their existence? If they were real, we'd have found something.
I tried to warn you about Saren, and you refused to face the truth.
Yeah, really?
Like, don't make the same mistake again.
Just because...
This is different. You proved Saren betrayed the Council. We all agree he's using the Geth to search for the conduit, but we don't really know why.
The Reapers are obviously just a myth, Commander. A convenient lie to cover Saren's true purpose. A legend he is using to bend the Geth to his will.
50,000 years ago, the Reapers wiped out all galactic civilization. If Saren finds the conduit, it will happen again.
Saren is a rogue agent on the run for his life. He no longer has the rights or resources of a Spectre. The Council has stripped him of his position.
That is not good enough. You know he's hiding somewhere in the Traverse. Send your fleet in!
A fleet cannot track down one man.
A Citadel fleet could secure the entire region, keep the Geth from attacking any more of our colonies.
Or it could trigger a war with the Terminus systems. We won't be dragged into a galactic confrontation over a few dozen human colonies.
Every time humanity asks for help, you ignore us.
Shepard's right. I'm sick of this council and its anti-human bull!
Ambassador, there is another solution. A way to stop Saren that does not require fleets or armies.
No! It's too soon. Humanity is not ready for the responsibilities that come with joining the Spectres.
It was a Turian Spectre who betrayed this council, and it was a human who exposed him. I've earned this.
Boom. I don't know, they have to like vote on it?
Commander Shepard, step forward.
Such formality in the face of like galactic war. Everyone's lining up to take a gander.
It is the decision of the Council that you be granted all the powers and privileges of the Special Tactics and Reconnaissance Branch of the Citadel.
Spectres are not trained, but chosen. Individuals forged in the fire of service and battle. Those whose actions elevate them above the rank and file.
Spectres are an ideal, a symbol, the embodiment of courage, determination, and self-reliance. They are the right hand of the Council, instruments of our will.
Spectres bear a great burden. They are protectors of galactic peace, both our first and last line of defense. The safety of the galaxy is theirs to uphold.
You are the first human Spectre, Commander. This is a great accomplishment for you and your entire species.
I'll be polite for once.
I'm honored, Counselor.
We're sending you into the Traverse after Saren. He's a fugitive from justice, so you are authorized to use any means necessary to apprehend or eliminate him.
I'll find him.
This meeting of the Council is adjourned.
Congratulations, Commander.
We've got a lot of work to do, Shepard. You're going to need a ship, a crew, supplies.
You'll get access to special equipment and training now. You should go down to the CSEC Academy and speak to the Spectre Requisitions Officer.
Anderson, come with me. I'll need your help to set all this up.
Bastard Dina is so like...
Bastard didn't even thank you.
What do you expect from a politician? Come on.
Right behind you, Shepard.
Squad!
Right, motherfucker, in my way. Son. I'll talk to that dude about this other dude's wife. Yeah. Alright, this way.
Bro, you're holding onto that dude's wife for, like, way too long. He wants to bury her.
Problem is, I understand why they haven't let him come, like, take his wife's body back. It's because she's fucking, like, husky. And not in the way that makes me, like, Not like burly. She's not a big person. She's literally just has a problem with the fact that she was probably turned into a husk by the Geth, and thus has, well, really no body left. Major bummer, bro. Major bummer. But I'll talk to this dude anyways. Because why not, right? Executor Palin.
My goodness, your command. Your activities made for quite a briefing in the diplomatic corps.
Quite a briefing.
Is there something I can do to assist you?
Stop stealing corpses.
You can cut the red tape for a grieving husband. I want you to release the body of Nerali Bhatia.
Commander, nothing would make me happier. I'm afraid, though, that it's not quite that simple. Serviceman Nerali Bhatia died on Eden Prime, as Mr. Bhatia no doubt told you. Her wounds are inconsistent with any type of weapon damage we've seen before. That is why her body is being held.
I don't care how badly the Geth mangled the body. It's the husband's right to claim her.
We are not holding Nerali Bhatia's body out of discretion. We are, frankly, holding the body for research.
Oh, that makes it so much better.
The tests we're conducting may lead to better defenses against Geth attacks. Respectfully, Serviceman Bhatia may save more lives in death than she did in life.
I'll tell Samesh. Next time you cut up a dead soldier, at least tell her husband the truth.
That was just the reaction we were hoping to avoid, Commander. But if you think it will help, tell Mr. Bhatia the truth. Perhaps he will understand. Please let me know if you have any other questions.
Probably just gonna have to lie to this dude, rather than, like, actually let him understand the fact that his wife has been chopped apart for the sake of science. Science! She blinded me with science.
Hello, Commander. Has any progress been made with Mr. Bosker? Will he return my wife's body?
It's not as simple as I'd hoped. The military needs...
My wife served the Alliance faithfully. She gave her life for humanity. And this is how they repay her.
I'm not going to go against the military, Mr. Bhatia. I can't help you.
Nerali always said that the military stick... I knew my wife might one day give her life for the military.
Burp. Make a decision. I'm sticking to my character profile in my brain. Normally I would have let him take his wife back, and I'm not that kind of an asshole. Okay, I will. I'd like to go to the docking bay, which I guess is in CSEC. Okay, let's see. Spectre Requisitions Officer. Is there? I already saw the requisitions guy, but now he'll give me shit because I'm a Spectre. Ooh, Spectre. What's up,
Hello,
homie?
Commander. Show me what you've got.
Sounds good. Just let me set you up. Oh, this must be a mistake. System's telling me to offer you our select stock. Spectre? Well, I heard about that, but I didn't realize it was you. Sorry, Commander.
Just show me what you've got.
I'll open the rare stocks for you, Commander. Enjoy.
The shit that I can't afford? Yeah, thanks. Not yet. Because I know...
If CSEC were better at its job, there'd be no need for bounty hunters like me.
I like that he's honest about his work. Like, he's just like,
bug it.
Yeah. To the docking bay! Ba-na-na-na-na-na-na.
So how about it, Garrus? Is this better than CSEC?
Fighting a rogue specter with countless lives at stake and no regulations to get in the way? I'd say that beats CSEC.
There may just be hope for you yet, Turian.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the camaraderie and banter. Come on, elevator. Stop moving. Please. There we go. So slow.
I've got big news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Treat her well, Commander.
I'll take good care of her, sir.
I know you will, Commander.
I want the truth. Why are you stepping down, sir?
You needed your own ship. A Spectre can't answer to anyone but the Council. And it's time for me to step down.
Come clean with me, Captain. You owe me that much.
I was in your shoes 20 years ago, Shepard. They were considering me for the Spectres.
Why didn't you ever mention this?
What was I supposed to say? I could have been a Spectre, but I blew it? I failed, Commander. It's not something I'm proud of. Ask me later and I'll tell you the whole story. For now, all you need to know is, I was sent on a mission with Saren, and he made sure the Council rejected me. I had my shot. It came and went. Now you have a chance to make up for my mistakes.
Saren's not going to get away this time.
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The Conduit. He's got his Geth scouring the Traverse looking for clues.
We had reports of Geth in the Pharos system shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact. And there have been sightings around Novaria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Novaria. Maybe you can figure out where the Conduit is before he does.
The Reapers are the real threat.
I'm with the Council on this one, Shepard. I'm not sure they even exist.
But if they do
exist...
Oh,
the naivety.
The Conduit's the key to bringing them back. Stop Saren from getting the Conduit, and we stop the Reapers from returning.
I'll stop him.
We have one more lead. Matriarch Benezia, the other voice in that recording? She has a daughter, a scientist who specializes in the Protheans. We don't know if she's involved, but it might be a good idea to try and find her. See what she knows. Her name's Liara, Dr. Liara Tassoni. We have reports she was exploring an archaeological dig on one of the uncharted worlds in the Artemis Tau Cluster.
Sounds like we should head for the Artemis Tau Cluster.
It's your decision, Commander. You're a Spectre now. You don't answer to us.
But your actions still reflect on humanity as a whole. You make a mess and I get stuck cleaning it up.
I'll do whatever it takes to stop Saren.
Not exactly the answer I was looking for, Shepard. Remember, you were a human long before you were a Spectre. I have a meeting to get to. Captain Anderson can answer any questions you might have.
I don't have any.
Yes, Commander?
No. I should go.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Because fuck, you know, waiting around. I've been stuck on this goddamn station for the last, like, half an hour. At least. Oh, wait. My favorite part, decontamination.
Decontamination in pro.
Heard what happened to Captain Anderson. Survives 100 battles and then gets taken down by backroom politics. Just watch your back, Commander. Things go bad on this mission, you're next on their chopping block.
Saren's out there somewhere, and we're gonna find him.
Everyone on this ship's behind you, Commander, 100%. Intercom's open. If you got anything you want to say to the crew, now's the time.
This is Commander Shepard speaking.
We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the Conduit. I won't lie to you, crew. This mission isn't going to be easy.
This began with an attack on a human settlement in the Traverse.
But we know Saren won't stop there. His Geth armies aren't going to stay on the far fringes of Citadel space.
The Council wants to ignore this.
That's no surprise. They never helped us in the past. No reason they'd start now. But we don't need their help. We can do this on our own.
Yeah.
Wherever Saren goes, we'll follow.
Wherever he searches for the conduit, we'll be there. We will hunt him to the very ends of the galaxy and bring him down.
This is the most important mission any of us have ever been on.
The fate of an entire galaxy is at stake. We will stop Saren, no matter what the cost.
Well said, Commander. Captain will be proud.
The Captain gave up everything so I could have this chance. We can't fail.
Yes, sir.
Alright, well then now that means I could control the star map, if I'm not mistaken. Star map, galaxy map. Mappity map. I said I was going to go to like two of those other places, those really important places. Now I'm going to like the most unimportant little place in the fucking galaxy. To Hydra! Hey, oh, Hydra. Wow! Blang, blang, bling.
Coming in. Patching it through.
The general distress call from the Sacred Angel Medical Transport. Critical system failure. Losing power. An emergency landing. Argos. Communications failing. Life support and emergency transponder. Won't last. Please hurry.
Well. That seems like a good heat hazard. Fuck. The weather hazards always kill me. And that and the giant worms. Same squad as always. Because they're the homies. I love how we drop the... That's a random one. survey that mineral. Yeah.
There's a wreckage. The signal must be coming from there.
Careful, Shepard.
Yeah, it's a trap!
Sad how, like, these planets are so poorly textured for how amazing the rest of the game looks. And the fact that you have, like, this minute little portion of them to visit. I think the new one will improve that, probably. Actual open world experience. Whoa. Loudy. It's like a cat, it auto-corrects everything. What be over here? Rocks. He thinks. Mercury. All-wheel drive. It's traction. A beast. Nothing gets this thing off. Nothing. Nothing can topple it. I mean, it'll roll, but it corrects right back. That was a little indelicate. This thing is taking a beating. Get us to the next planet and probably call it for today, actually. Thank you. go to Pinnacle Station. Never been one for obeying only main directives of the story.
Isn't that Commander Shepard? The human Spectre?
Whatever. Spectre or no, it's always fun to see humans get pummeled in the simulator. Go pester Ahern, human. I'm on duty.
Ah, Commander Shepard. Welcome to Pinnacle Station. I'm Admiral Thaddeus Ahern.
I'm glad I got the invite. Where do we begin?
You'll be training in the combat simulator. After each round, you'll see how you fared against your competitors.
I'll go check it out.
Carry on.
Don't worry, Commander. Ahern's tough to impress.
So, you must be the famous Commander Shepard. I'm tech specialist Alud Akran, lead programmer on the... Do you need something? I'm sure I have a few minutes before someone forgets their password and comes crying to me for help.
Let's try a new simulation.
New competitors are restricted to low-impact missions till they learn the ropes. Which combat mode? Time trial, capture, survival, or hunt?
Let's try one of the timed missions.
And which course? I've got the warehouse or tropical courses. We give you some dummy grenades and medigel. If you try to use a real grenade, I will turn off every safety measure this season.
Get moving! This is a time trial!
What do you need?
I want to give the last test another shot.
The projectors are warming up. You can start.
Get moving! This is a time trial!
Enemy contact!
Launch shields!
Yourself.
shields!
That looked like it hurt. That's it, Shepard. You know what happened.
What? Fourth, not bad.
Get me back in that simulator. Nothing makes my deal.
What do you need?
Let's try a new simulation.
I'm here to which combat mode? Time trial, capture, survival, or hunt?
Sign me up for
all right. I can get you set up in either the subterranean level or the volcanic level.
Subterranean.
The projectors are warming up.
Oh, Shepard! You need to kill to keep a hunt mission going.
We got them all, Shepard.
No, we didn't. That was lame. They walked him out of my line of sight right as he was... Wow, okay. What's the quest marker for?
What do you need?
What's with the attitude?
I'm a technical genius on a station full of soldiers who only respect battlefield prowess. It's more than a little frustrating.
You help keep these soldiers at their best. That's extremely
valuable. I suppose so. It would just be nice to get credit for it once in a while.
What am I supposed to be doing in these simulations?
That depends. We have time trial, capture, hunt.
Damn. Did he just kill us? Wow. Well, that was my own fault, admittedly. More than I think it was his doing. I got too close. I got too ambitious. Trying to attack him. The second round shouldn't be a problem. Normally they're a little more damaged, D.A. I was surprised it took him that long to actually hit me.
Hit me! Hit me!
Pop up, come on. I know you're there. The only reason I went to that particular distress beacon is because I thought it was actually going to be something relevant. Shock. I didn't see it coming. It's in the... No, it was in the Athens cluster, if I remember. Or Athens system. Salamis? No, it was, No, it wasn't. It was the Macedon cluster. Macedon system. Artemis Town cluster, Macedon system. I say that, but I know it's not. Takes damage. It's glitchier and glitchier the more you fight, it seems.
You must die!
I don't think so.
You must die!
Not bad. Yeah, I think you're right. They at least have stuff here. Where's all their stuff? I mean, I'm just surprised that there's less stuff than I expected for a place of this. Oh, there's some stuff. Description. Encryption seal too low. I really didn't want to back into cover that way. Nice. I'll take it. Hell yeah. Sorry, Rex. The fact that exiting the building required a, I do want to return to Normandy. I want to go find this planet. Fucking whatever planet she's supposed to be on. This mission, I'm gonna call it. I know I keep amending when I'm gonna stop playing, but when you get sucked in, it's gonna be hard to get out.
Commander, I'm picking up some strange readings. Really strange, like off the damn charts. It looks like it's coming from an underground complex a few clicks away from the drop zone.
Fun begin. It's the environments you actually have to go to that they take the time with. I think that's gonna change. Again, drama is really gonna vault us ahead in terms of how we look at space-based RPGs. Another one to check out, and one I may play on occasion, especially as its alpha continues to release periodically as Star Citizen. It's the new one from Chris Roberts of Wing Commander fame, which I never played, but I can say with absolute certainty that the man is an absolute perfectionist. So whenever that game finally comes out, it will be amazing. Hello, Geth ship. That was a level up. I'm never gonna turn that away. Okay. Thank you.
Only a fool punches a gnatbat in the mouth. We should sneak around and pull its tail.
So fatigued. That's not good.
got them all, Shepard.
Whoa! More experience, that's all that means. More XP, more money, more gear. No complaints. Dull moments in this game is the driving to nowhere. Oh wait, we come upon a predetermined set of enemies. Yay! Who can't possibly hope to harm us because they're... Oh my god. Is he just too... have any effect. The Colossus is the Colossi, quote unquote, and the armatures are the ones that actually do damage, but the only problem is that there's so few of them and their hitbox is so big that you can just mollywop the crap out of them while they waste time trying to kill you. And they don't do enough damage to actually damage you. Two in a tunnel, it's just not enough. Good. Minus 9 on the accuracy. Up 12 on damage. Take the edge too. Explorer 3. No, I have that already, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Versus Duelist 2. Just down in damage production, but up in shields. It's worth it. Give him this one. The Banshee 3. Omnichel the Hurricane and the Banshee 2. Save now? Awesome. remember correctly, there's about to be an armature that drops down out of the sky. Yep. Sounds about right. And then we go inside. Dr. Tassoni is magically unaware of everything that's been going on. Oh, first it's these things. I hate these fuckers. What just killed me? I hope it auto-saved. Oh, crap. I might have to run this whole fucking thing again.
Over there!
Oh, lordy. That's what I get.
I've lost shields! Oh my god, they never take cover properly. Shields down. No shit, shields down. Synthetics damage right now. learned my lesson. Saving is important, as always. Forward. Not encountering any contacts. I think I might have actually killed everybody I needed to for that section of this. Why the music is still so intense, though, is beyond me. Yeah. Saved up. Save here. I know that bastard's gonna try and take me down. I don't know how I got killed last time. Goes. Save. In we go. This is probably where I'm going to call time, because we're 2 minutes away from the 4-hour mark, and I think that should be it. I resume this tomorrow morning, Thursday morning, say between 9:30 and 10 for another 3 hours, probably, and then Thursday night, you can expect, tomorrow's Wednesday, never mind, I have no idea what day of the week it is, Definitely Thursday morning for this. Potentially tomorrow as well. But definitely Thursday, regular time slot, 9:30 a.m., 10:30, or 10, 9:30 to 10 a.m. is start time. And multiplayer in the evening, either Overwatch or Battlefield 1 on PS4 instead of the PC. Overwatch will be on the computer, though. Regardless of that, it's been a pleasure. And until next time, hope you have a great day. And